keep the talking to a minimum and respect the musicians and the people beside you. So, with all of that said, I'd like to introduce you to this Brian and BJ of Six Bridges. So put your hands together.
I think the musician might be coming up in about 45 minutes.
Yeah, I was about to say, if you guys want to make noise while we're playing, that's fine with us. I actually had to give my cigarettes to my girlfriend so I wouldn't smoke up on stage, so.
I love that one.
Yeah, you.
I mean, I don't really love that, but.
That's right, love.
That's right.
You ready?
Thank you. sea. It will rise up to heaven and come back down to me as rain.
Thank you.
guess this song's about leaving that same small town. A photograph there on the dash, torn to pieces, out the window, too far and gone, I can't turn back. Well, I roll on, I roll fast, and I roll on, to a bit of sunshine and a brighter star. And I don't know just how long and just how far I'm gonna go, so I roll on. From the night on the way home, morning breaks in San Antonio. It's so cheap, but she's still running, so I guess I'll carry on. Shove it east for the Atlantic, I can hear her calling me. Shove it out into the ocean, drowning with her memory. Well, I roll on, I roll fast, and I roll on to a bit of sunshine and a brighter star.
Sometimes we make
across the floor as I come walking through the barroom door. I see you fade away as your eyes fall on me. Oh, but we both made our minds to go our way and leave the other far behind. Standing here, girl, I swear we tried. We can't set it free. Little darling, don't you cry. Little darling, don't you weep for me. Don't let us see you staring. You're burning holes in my disguise. I hope I can see you at night. See you looking back and laughing, I won't grieve. I'll see you moving on. Darling, please be strong and don't you cry for me. It's the sweetest kind of poison. It's a pleasant shot of pain. The one that brings the laughter. It's the very reason that you cry. If we can let it go, we might find what we've been missing, baby. Who's to know? Well, I've heard the stars heal so slow. Still, we gotta try. Little darling, don't you cry. Little darling, don't you weep for me. Don't let it see you staring. You're burning holes in my disguise. See you looking back and laughing, I won't grieve. I see you moving on. Darling, please be strong and don't you cry for me.
Little bubble. I have to laugh out loud, 'cause ain't it funny how I thought
thought you'd bring me anything, girl. You are just trouble. It's cliche, but true that when you're down in blue, well, you laugh because you just cannot cry. So I'm sorry, this is cold, but baby, I'm getting too damn old to bother myself with the who, what, when, where's, or why. Baby, just let me finish my beer, honey, and I'll be on my way. I said you come and go as you please, but don't come up bugging me to reminisce about them good old days. Cause them good old days were with all that great, and tomorrow ain't as bad as it seems. So I'll be leaving now, yeah, you might see me around, even if it's only in your dreams. Even if it's only in your dreams, I said, baby, only in your dreams.
Broken heart, Lord. Too long in my days of dragging on, running here to heaven.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it. Don't lie to these folks and pretend we haven't written 10 songs. And we put this empty piece of paper up here to make y'all think we had a set list or something.
It's actually blank. There's nothing on here.
You
want to
do rhythm?
Good folks, we're Sixers. My name is BJ. My name My name's BJ, this is my buddy Brian, am I right?
I'm sure they're trying to confuse you right now.
Confusing me, man, that's good enough. The song we heard, Roger Craig and Jack Hager do, it just seems to fit, so let me finish up with this one.
Well, I'd like to take this time to thank the people gathered around me. At least we've come this far, it's been a really tough road. There were nights I sang so low, it seemed hard to imagine. You pick me up and help me carry the load. But sometimes we sing to an empty house. Some nights we pack them in. It's hard to know if we're waiting to lose or losing to win. It takes a lot of good folks to open all the doors. You gotta knock and again. Gave us what we needed, so thank you for believing. We got a 1 foot in. And here I go, one more time. Giving all I've got, word by word and line by line. One more time. At a time, loving what I do, laying it all on the line.
Back up your gear, it's out on the highway. I'll keep moving, just to see you around.
Maybe in some small with my case at my feet on the ground. One thing's for certain, one thing I know, nothing's gonna slow us down. We're gonna let it roll, gonna lay it down. The same old songs in brand new times. Sometimes we sing to an empty house. Some nights we pack them in. It's hard to know if we're waiting to lose or losing to win. It takes a lot of good folks to open up the doors. We had a knock again. He gave us what we needed, so thank you for believing. We got 1 foot in.
Yeah,
we'll see you down the highway.
But you've been great too. We really appreciate it. Great applause for you.
What do you think about Six Bridges? Yeah, right. This is our first time at the Clubhouse concert series, and we're pretty impressed. All right, there's some food left over. If anybody would like to have some seconds, just go help yourself. Now I'd like to introduce a Texas singer-songwriter. He's a dual tones recording artist. Anyway, Mr. Radney Foster.
She seemed a little confused about that. But y'all get to hear how I wrote him in my living room, so. Yeah.
Woo!
Just come along. Music, and if you don't like honky tonk music, you're pretty much in the wrong joint.
What are we gonna do? I got a set list, but that doesn't mean I'm gonna follow it. So.
this one. This is a song about falling in love in Austin, Texas. It's a true story, and for some unknown reason, I changed the name of the woman after I'd written it. And, which, at the time, I kept, you know, thinking that my wife needed some sort of anonymity, and you know, it's not like anybody didn't figure it out. You know. Anyway, if you haven't fallen in love in Austin, Texas, I highly recommend it. It's a good thing.
Linda's going downtown tonight, 'cause she didn't want to be alone. But she's got everything in this world except the love of a man at home. But she keeps on hoping that door is open. Down on Broadway, she knows the place where the dreams rave on. Tonight ain't gonna be the same old, same old. Job and running off to Mexico. She's just bluffing, but another margarita, who knows where both might go. And some of her insanity is starting to rub off on me. In a dream we can dream of, she says, might come true.
Been known to forget the words to new songs. Been known to forget the words to old songs. This also is country music. It took me a lot of therapy and a lot of years to come to the realization that I didn't always write country songs and that was okay. But that this really is a real country song, that there's kind of a little bit of.
Thank you.
do all those rumors of my demise. Well, they're just not true. I've moved on way past you. Studio record, and I make great stocking stuffers. Thought I'd bring this up now. Everybody wave at Joe. Joe, stand up and wave at everybody. That's Joe right there. Joe sells my t-shirts, please, and my CDs and stuff. And y'all please go talk to her even sometime after the show. But you know, I was having one of those days where everything that could go wrong did go wrong, and I think it involved a professional crisis earlier in the day. And then later that evening, all my kids got sick and my wife, and I had to be nursemaid, and I collapsed in the bed about 8:30, which means I woke up about 3:30 in the morning, and I was, you know, sort of checking on the kids, made sure, you know, they were all right. They were asleep, and kind of muttering at God and everything about my situation. So I reckon for the craziest dang way to make a living in the whole wide world. The kids are driving me crazy. but it sure feels right.
Dang it.
I gotta go down in the basement and write that song. So it goes like this. Well, I don't know where this is going, baby. It's good, it's hard, it's easy, it's crazy, but it sure feels right. It feels alright. Spinning out balance, this is out of control, but it steady as a rockin' and won't let go. It sure feels right. It feels alright. Every kiss, every touch, not sure that mine can take this much. I feel so weak, so strong. It's the wildest ride I've ever been on. It's clear, it's true. It's me and it's you. While the safety valve just got knocked clean off, we're running kind of hot, no telling what it cost, but it sure feels right. Yeah, it feels all right. Love's so beautiful, it scares you to death. It grabs you, it shakes you, it makes a big mess, but it sure feels right. Yeah, it feels all right. Every kiss, every touch, not sure that mine can take this much. I feel so weak, so strong. It's the wildest ride I've ever been on. It's clear, it's true. It's me and it's you, and it sure feels right to me. It's a real sweet ride, it's a real slick fit, it's a dangerous deal. It's more than I can handle, darling. I love the way it feels with you. It sure feels right to me. Every kiss, every touch, not sure that my heart can take this much. I feel so weak, so strong. It's the wildest ride I've ever been on. It's clear, it's true. It's me and it's you, and it sure feels right. Yeah, it feels so right. Yeah, it sure feels right. Sure feels right to me, yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Y'all want to hear another new song?
Clearer. I don't have a mama's least I'd probably make them again. But if I had it all to do over, sure I'd win and lose just as much. Spend less time on right and wrong, and a lot more time on love. Half of my mistakes I made, cause I was moving too quickly. Half of my mistakes I make, cause my heart was moving too slow. Nobody can tell you a damn thing if you ain't listening. Oh, half of my mistakes I've made, cause I couldn't let go. But if I had it all to do over, I'm sure I'd win and lose just as much. Spend less time on right and wrong, and a lot more time on love. Half of my mistakes I'd give anything to change how it ended. Half of my mistakes, God, I wouldn't change a thing.
New songs because I'm going in to make a new record in February. Hey, all right. There are some fans out there somewhere. But let me tune this thing back to normal land.
Where are you recording the album?
We don't know yet. Where am I going to record the record?
Yeah.
We're talking about renting a house. I'm doing it in the house. I have enough studio gear to fill this whole bar. So we're talking about renting a house in the Hill Country and doing it there. Everybody always seems to think you need stuff you don't really need. Well, you need it, but we're just going to haul it there with us. Vibe is just as important as technique. Works that way sometimes in songwriting. Or just in general in life, you know.
Speaking of vibe,
this I'm going to play another new song, and then I'll get back to ones y'all know. But I have a 16-month-old daughter, which is a really neat thing. And nobody told me I was going to fall head over heels in love with her. They didn't explain this to me. It didn't come with a flow chart or nothing. You know? But her newest trick is, and she's got two big brothers, and you know she's going to be well protected between me and them. But her newest trick is that when she's really happy about you, she throws her head back, closes her eyes, and puckers up. Wants you to kiss her, you know. Which is really good behavior for a 16-month-old child, but bad behavior for a 16-year-old child. It means I got a cure of it at some point in the future. You know? May not kiss every man that walks in the house. So anyway, she was the inspiration for this latest song, and usually by the last chorus, everybody's singing along with this. At least in the last several bars that I've played this in, it's been that way, and it's a kid's song, but it's kind of, I don't know, works as a drinking song too for some reason. A little baby's like to suck on their toes, but why they do it, nobody knows. You best do it while you're young, can't do it when you're old. Little babies like to suck on their toes. Little roly-poly on the living room floor never seems to get much rest. She could have a tummy or a choopy, but it's funny that the toes always seem to taste best. Little babies like to suck on their toes. Why they do it, nobody knows. You best do it while you're young, can't do it when you're old. Little babies like to suck on their toes. Twisting and a turning is just the natural yearning of a pint-sized contortionist. Respectable, but they're so darn delectable. How's a kid gonna resist? A little baby's like to suck on their toes. How, why they do it, nobody knows. You best do it while you're young, can't do it when you're old. A little baby's like to suck on their toes. From England to Japan, suck them every chance you can. Parents don't know it's true. Knockoff, a kid will pull a sock off, cause only a toe will do. Little babies like to suck on their toes, everybody. Why they do it, nobody knows. Best do it while you're young, can't do it when you're old. Little babies like to suck on their toes, yeah they do. Little babies like to suck on their toes all the time. Little babies like to suck on their toes. Song off my new album, which is probably about how I got the baby in the first place. Thank you.
bet it the truth is similar to me. I know what you do. I'm not gonna waste your time. But trust me, baby, I'll be there for you. I have a soul to cling to. I know we can fly.
Everybody knows that love is the finest thing in this world. I believe you can spend a lifetime running away if you want to, girl. If love is what you want, I got what you need, but now your face is gone.
He's a really good guy, you know, all that other stuff notwithstanding. But it was interesting. He fell in love with this song. I made a record a few years back that's no longer available called See What You Want to See. It's out of print. But, so if you find one on eBay, you better snatch it up. We actually found 30 in a warehouse somewhere and put them back up on our website. We had sold the last 3,000 ourselves. We sold out of those 30 in 2 days. So if we find some more, we'll let you guys know. And I have an email list with Joe. We can let you know about future concerts and that kind of stuff too. But, Keith Urban fell in love with this song. And if any of y'all listen to like The Wolf, they, you know, this last summer they were playing it kind of every other song, I think. Which is good because I'm adding a screen porch and a bedroom onto my house, and we're gonna call it that. It's going to be called the Keith Urban Memorial Wing. You know. This is pretty much going to pay for it. So. But in any case, the whole second verse is sort of a peyote-induced, you know, mystical kind of West Texas thing. And, but which he completely did not understand, and mostly I think because of my West Texas speech impediment. And he totally got the words wrong. But the words he sang were great. I mean, they totally work. I understand how he misunderstood what I said, and what he thought I said when he thought I'd said it was really pretty good. You know, but that wasn't what I said, so. This one was much more mystical and drug-induced kind of thing, so. Like I said, but you'll get it. It's okay. Well, it ticks just like a time. Never lets up on you. Love. Let's just start it again. Let it take just like a time. Never lets up on you. But who said life was easy? The job is never through. It runs till we're ragged. It'll harden our hearts. Love you's a dead rift while we both start falling apart. For if it is raining on Sunday, storming like crazy, we'll hide under the covers all afternoon. Maybe whatever comes Monday can take care of itself, 'cause we've got better things that we can do when it's raining. Cross in Mexico, no kisses like the incense of a prayer nailed to the door. Our surrender is much sweeter when we both let go. Let the water wash our bodies clean and love wash our souls. At the ranch here. If you want to hear my version of the song, call those guys up. They'll play it. They play my music, and I really, really appreciate it. A bunch of guys. So, my granddaddy was a rancher, and when I was 13 years old, he had a Ford LTD automobile that was as long as that bar over there. And it was powder blue, and it had a dark blue Landau roof. And it was the most pimped out automobile you ever shined your eyes on. It was just unbelievable. And, but it was the 70s, and I thought it was really, really cool. And I was 13 years old. I wanted to learn how to drive. I didn't want to learn how to drive any car. I wanted to learn how to drive that car bad. And so I bugged him and bugged him and bugged him until, you know, he finally threw the keys at me one Saturday and said, "Come on, son, we're going to town. You're going to learn how to drive." And I was a little shaky. But we did it, and you know, till I was grown, and I had written this song, I thought that this rite of passage was unique to me. My brothers and sisters and all my cousins, you know, clued me in and said, what, you kidding? Everybody, you always did it. And, you know, which kind of burst my bubble in a big way. But I said, hey, you know, I'm the only one who wrote a song about it. So I don't know if I should bring that up at the Christmas dinner table.
But,
We drove every farm to market road we could find, you know, until we finally got to Buna, Texas, and the thriving metropolis of Buna. And we parked in front of Mixon Brothers department store, which is the only department store I've ever been in that sells horse feed. I swear to God. And they had this big divider, and then one side they had, like, you know, women's apparel and suits and shoes and, you know, stuff like that, and appliances and all that stuff. And on the other side, they had, you know, like tack and halters and, no, not those kind of halters, for horses, Wranglers and all that kind of stuff. And I always thought it was weird that the only place, you could buy, you know, regular pants, nice pants over on one side, but you had to buy blue jeans over where the horse feed was. But we got out of the car, and he handed me a $20 bill when I gave him the keys, and he said, son, you don't have to tell your mama everything. When I was just before my granddaddy took me to town one afternoon, we drove FTD, wore a big white Stetson and two-tone cowboy boots. Said, Sonny, go as it handed me a 20 just to see the look on my face. Said, don't tell your mama nothing about it, don't spend it all in one place. See a text, fall in money, get the deal done, fall in money to have a little fun, fall in money to pay a few bills, eat a steak dinner, cure a couple bills, fold in money and need a little staff, some greenback dollars, a cold hard cash, save it for a rainy day or throw away a little bit of sun. Takes folding money to get the deal done. I ever since the day I learned to earn a dollar, I've been taking his advice to heart. Cause when a man finds the courage to keep his cash, some romance is bound to start. And now romance is just like money. You can always get more if you got it. And let me tell you, friends, I'm a lot more handsome with a C-note in my pocket. It takes falling money, get the deal done. Falling money to have a little fun. Falling money to pay a few bills. Take a girl dancing or cure a couple L's. Falling money, you need a little staff. Some brain back out of the cold hard cash. Save it for a rainy day or throw away a little bit. It takes folding money, yeah, so does. You can give it to a charity and in some disparity, stock up your refrigerator. You can marry an amenity, it'll kill you if you let it. You can blow it with nothing to show. It'll make you wild or fatter, but the truth of the matter is can't take it with you when you go. Better spend a little falling money, get the deal done. Falling money to have a little fun. Falling money to pay a few bills. Spread a little round, let it cure a couple ills. Need a little staff, some greenback dollars, a cold hard cash. Save it for a rainy day or throw away a little bit of sun. It takes folding money. Get the deal done. Folding money.
out loud. Do just sit still, please.
Please.
Please. So was there please on here? I'll do it. Okay. That's another song. I'll do. All right. Now I got to read.
Besides me, riding around in John Wardlaw's El Camino back in about 1976 or 7. You were good? Really? If you were, then you would know that that one of the things that, you know, we thought was really cool. Be able to listen to Waylon Jennings 8 tracks and you know, hide the beard under the, you know, down in the floorboard. And you know, one of the cooler things to do was to be able to, you know, leave rubber at the light in front of the courthouse. Unless your dad's a lawyer and he was standing on the courthouse lawn, I suppose he's just down in the court. You know. Because we kind of thought we had invented rock and roll. And it, you know. If you listen carefully to whoever the young man is in the second verse of this song, I have no idea who he's talking about.
Just sit still, kill some time. shoot the breeze, enjoy the ride, take a breath, take it slow, relax, son, let it go, just sit still.
Come on in.
straight to the truth. If you needed a lover and a friend, yeah, if you need a lover and a friend, baby, I'm
I'm not that same old you. Getting up.
one of my mother's dear friends, Sarah Winters, when I was loading my Volkswagen full of everything that I owned to move to Nashville at 20 and get involved in the music business, baked me a banana bread. But she didn't really want to bake me a banana bread. It's just that she was trying to get over there to convince me that I was making a foolish mistake, and because my parents had been incapable of convincing me of that. The banana bread was a good excuse. This was, of course, 2 weeks after I had woken my parents up in the middle of the night, and I said, "Mom and Daddy, I've been thinking about this, and I've been praying about it, and I can't eat, and I can't sleep, and trying to figure out how to tell y'all that I think God wants me to drop out of college and become a songwriter." Which my daddy sat bolt upright in bed and said, "Son, I've known God a long time. You don't want any son of mine to drop out of college for a song." So, and we can see how well that worked, right? So anyway, Sarah said, "Radney," she said, "the music business is just like rodeo, and it'll get in your blood and you can't get it out." She, of course, was from a ranching family and knew a lot of rodeo folks. I said, "You're right, Sarah, but I'll be careful." She gave me the banana bread, and I got the car and drove off. And that haunted me. You know, I thought about that for a long, long time. And about 3 years after that, I was at probably one of my lowest points and thinking about moving home and starting over again, all those kind of things. I started thinking, you know, rodeo riders are just like musicians, they're dreamers. And most people think this song is really about rodeo riders, but what it's really about is dreamers. And dreamers are people we need. We need them real bad. Because they change our lives and they change the world around. They change the way we think, they change what we listen to, they change the way we feel. They document the events in our lives. And whether it's being a songwriter or following a dream of sports or, you know, making your neighborhood a better place to live or helping raise some money so some kid's better off than they were when they started out, gets a college scholarship, has something to eat. It's the dreamers are the ones we need, so keep dreaming. I can hear the wind whisper my name, telling me it's time to head out again. My horse is trailered and the lights shut down, long overdue for heading out of town. Got a fever that they call the rodeo, snowing and making that show. Time to time you hit dirt, go on, pin another number to the back of my shirt, and I'll ride that pony fast. Like a cowboy from the past, be young and wild and free, like Texas. To the Astrodome, from New York City down to San Antonio, boys are riding for legendary fame. And I run his doggone, though we ride just the same. Our hearts are getting broken and our heads are getting busted. We'll always believe in the same, do we trust it? Now be those nights when glory comes round, and we'll tip our hats and wave to the crowd and then ride. Like Texas in 1880.
see that buckle hanging there on your belt. Ask you just how it felt to ride that pony fast, like a cowboy from the hills, beyond the wild and free, like Texas in 1880, like Texas in 1880, like Texas.
Thank you all very, very much. God bless you all. Thanks for coming out. Center on September the 11th, and they are alive and well because of the bravery of New York firefighters and police. And it was about this time of year, that year, that I went up there right before Christmas, and we had dinner with several of my friends just because we wanted to see them. We felt like it was our patriotic duty to go up there and spend our money. So it was really, really cold, I remember. And we were having dinner with this friend of mine, Judy O'Brien, who's up there. She writes novels. She's a novelist. Of course. But she told me a story about a guy who was her next-door neighbor. His name was Dave Fontana. September the 11th had been his anniversary. His wife was a school teacher, and he had a little boy. He'd worked a double shift the night before to get the day off. She talked about, you know, what an amazing guy he was, and what a real leader in the community. And I was always kind of the guy in the neighborhood who was, you know, taking care of things, making sure that it was just a little bit better place to live. Of course, he worked that double shift, and the shift change came around right as he was getting off, and the alarms went off for the World Trade Center, and he got on the Rescue Squad 1's fire engine and went to the World Trade Center, which is right across the Brooklyn Bridge, and there were some of the first guys there, and he never made it home. And I was just completely haunted and devastated by that story after barely finished dinner. I remember as I was walking home to my hotel room, I got home and my wife went to sleep, and I wrote down about 30 names of people that I thought, you know, I really owe something to those people, and I've never really thought about it all the time. There's so many people I owe a debt of gratitude to in my life that I can never thank enough. I'm course, you can't write a song about 30 people. They're going to be really, really long. So I just picked three. She'd retired from teaching school. She'd pick my son up in her arms on Sundays, teach him all about the golden rule. I heard those stories about Selma and Tuskegee, how she helped Martin build the jails. All I know is she had the strength of 10 grown men, even though her hands were small and frail. That he never got back down.